Just a wild dream? Well, maybe, but there are still places that dreams can be turned into reality. This is Dodger Town in Vero Beach, Florida, where for one fabulous week, men from all over the country got together with Dodger heroes from the past to learn from the best how to play the game they've loved for so long.
Do you think you can find the ball this time in the batting cage?
I don't care so much about it in there. It's when we get into the games. That's when I want to make sure I find it. There, it doesn't make too much difference in the batting cage. Or on the tee. You don't need a ball when you're on the tee. Fantasy. Just make believe it's there.
This guy is the most fantastic manager I've ever played under, right?
You're kidding.
Oh, no.
Extension of his bar tab is unbelievable.
How about that, huh? Who would have ever expected that from me?
Yeah, over $400, and I mean, the guy comes up smiling.
I love the heavy drinkers.
I know that there's some of you...
First item on the agenda of the first day is to outline what the campers can expect this week, and to go over safety rules in order to avoid needless injuries. The need to be careful and to keep a reasonable pace is very real. Trying to do too much too soon can have painful results.
They'll tell you, you're going to have one great week. You really are. And they're going to have a great week because of your enthusiasm and because of the enthusiasm and the baseball knowledge of these guys down in the front row. So forget about it. Take care of yourself. Watch your injuries and everything. Don't go all out the first day. Save a little bit. Save a little bit for that big day on Friday when you have to play the instructors. So have a good time this week. We'll start right out alphabetical-wise. Ralph Branca, great pitcher with the Dodgers. Greatest catcher of all time, Roy Campanella. Tommy Davis, baseball's best hitter in 62 and 63. Hall of Famer, Don Blaisdell. 12 years pitching, most of it with the Dodgers, Carl Erskine. Outstanding outfielder and all-around player with the Dodgers in Brooklyn, Carl Parrillo. One of the most popular Dodgers of all time, Sweet Lou. Bullpen ace of the Dodgers, Clem Levine. 16 seasons in the big leagues, Ken McMullen. Winner of 6 straight Golden Gloves, Wes Parker. Present pitching coach of the Dodgers, Ron Paranowski. Where'd that come from? Master of the changeup, Johnny Padres. Winning percentage, 602. In the major leagues, Preacher Rowe. I made a mistake and signed this little fella. Became the National League Rookie of the Year with the Dodgers in 69. Eddie Sizemore. Hall of Famer, Duke Snyder. These guys are more than willing and able to help you any way they can to improve your baseball, to increase your knowledge of the game. They will do it. They'll stay out here and work with you. They'll do all kinds of things to help you have a great week here. Relax, join in, and have one hell of a time. Okay, let's get out here and stretch with Bill.
Knows how to spend his money.
Oh, good.
Bend your legs. Yeah, keep your shoulders back on the ground like that.
Starting today and for the rest of the week, the stretching exercises will be something that everybody looks forward to. Boy, that feels good.
Hi, Mom.
A major part of playing baseball is, of course, running. Running is good for the legs, good for the lungs, good for the... What was running good for again?
Jimmy Johnson says, okay, good, I'll put that on my calendar.
Yeah.
Turn around.
Come on.
Throw it a line, Carl.
Never like this in Arabia, was it, Henry?
What you might have to
do is get up. Getting like about 20.
Oh, I got to run for this guy.
Oh, God, you got to give him the right deal, right?
I'm not sure.
Hands up over your head.
Just when we start to think we're having fun, we get to do a little more stretching again.
Well, now on your stomach. Hands to
the Dodger trainer, Bill Buehler, hopes everybody's having as much of a good time as he is.
Set the example and people recognize that you're wild.
One of the major goals of an adult baseball camp is to make the various teams as competitive as possible. Throughout the week, they'll be playing each other, with the eventual winner starting and playing for the first 2 innings against the instructors in the final game on Friday. With that in mind, most of the first morning at camp is devoted to evaluating the campers to put together teams that are as even as possible. Make no mistake about it, these managers and coaches want to win. Within the fun atmosphere of the camp, there's sort of a grim rivalry. As the week goes on, managers are apt to try just about anything to get an edge in order to put a W up on the board. So, with clipboard in hand, they watch and listen and write, and perhaps even try to get a look at what the other guy has written down. It was even rumored that one coach put 4 stars beside a camper's name and let the other coaches see it. Sort of a CIA in cleats. All this maneuvering will culminate shortly in a player draft that will determine the makeup of the various teams. It's a good system. It worked out well for this camp, especially for the team that won. The Sarasota team thought it was a perfect system.
Like this, you're going to take one step when you want to throw, because this is the lane you throw off of, right? Well, that's very quick, very hard to do. If you end up having this leg back, this leg off to the side, you have a lot of movement in case of, you know, freedom of the arm. Now, as you pick this up, all you have to do is come up crow hop, and this isn't this the leg you throw off of anyway? So you're really under much better control by doing that.
That's it?
Slow down. Go and get it. There you go. Trying to give you a good better balance, that's all. Ready? Go on, go on. Move your feet. Slow down. Go. Two hands. Two hands. There you go. Oh, watch it. There one. Ready? Atta boy. Ready? That's it.
Caught, Roger.
I got it.
Got to howl right away.
Make sure that you run.
Yes, sir.
Back him up.
As we said, you'll have 10 seconds for each pick.
Here they go. Having drawn for pricking order, the draft begins. Each manager has 10 seconds to make a selection. This is serious stuff. Just look at those faces.
Ignore these X's. They don't mean anything on here. They were just guys who requested roommates, and we can't.
You want to give their positions?
Okay.
Now is the camper's turn. Since the names are put on the chart in no particular order of selection, there's no clue to it has who was picked when. That's fair. It also keeps salary demands on the cheap side. Managers are like that.
Greg, any opening lines?
Hi there, my name's John LaPuma from Old Brook, Illinois. This is my second year here. Having a good year here and a good time, and hopefully going for a second Cy Young Award. Thanks.
Thank you for this week. It's been the greatest of my life. And Harris, I told you I could do it.
Hi, I'm David Pines from Thousand Oaks. Hi, Judy. This was more fun than the marathon. Thank you.
Barry Siegel, Woodland Hills, California. Honey, greatest week of my life. Hello, David. Hello, Michael.
Jeff Gargiulo, Naples, Florida. Valerie, you're right. I should have stayed home.
John Johnson, Cleveland, Ohio. Phil Negro, better watch out. Here I come.
Jack Funamura, Stockton, California. Hi, Mom. Love you, Jan. Love you, Justin, Jamie, and Joshua.
Chuck Firestein, Encino, California. Having a super week. Hi, Kathy. Hi, John. Hi, Jeff. Hi, Chris.
Hi, Rich Bernard from Calais, Maine. I just want to say hello to Janelle and Susan. Having a great week here at Dodgertown.
Hi, I'm John DiCaro from Laguna Niguel, California. I want to say hi to Shelley, Gino, and Julie. Baseball has been very good to me this week.
Harvey, thanks for this great gift. I'm having a wonderful time down here, and I will never, ever forget what you've done for me. This has really been an absolute dream come true, and I think maybe I'll take up an offer and let you do this for me again next year, too, if you want to.
Hi there, Jerry Dimon, Huntington, New York. Everything's going good.
Hi, everyone. We're having a good camp. We're working as hard. We're looking forward to the opening of the season, and we think we can go all the way this year. And we'll see you all back when we get back home in a few months. Take care.
I want to thank the Dodgers for letting me be a kid again for a week. It's been terrific.
This has been one of the most incredible weeks I've ever spent. I can't believe I'm here. And there are times I have to pinch myself to realize it. It's really been great.
Hello there. It's Bob Hansen. I want to thank the Dodger organization for a fantastic week. It's been a lot of fun. Look forward to many more years of the same.
the hand. You put the bat in your fingers with the hand. There you go. There you go.
Just like in spring training, a lot of time and effort goes into the instructional phase of the camp. Here in the batting cages, Duke Snider and Tommy Davis work with the campers to improve their hitting abilities. Sometimes a small adjustment in a swing or a stance will produce a dramatic improvement in batting average.
Okay. Hold it. Not fly.
But that was because he broke his finger.
Pitchers, although they probably won't admit it, can also be helped. Here, Clem LeBlanc, Carl Erskine, Johnny Podras, and John Drysdale go over the finer points of their art.
All right. Let's see, hold a guy on base. You can take your sign in that position.
Deliver a quick step.
A quick step, and obviously that's to give the guy on first less chance. Also, you have to think a little about your shoulder position. You can't start too wide open, because the minute you start to the plate, now he can go. So you try to hit a happy medium. It may not be perfectly square to the plate, but it has to be so you can still get a view of him, and then when you're ready to deliver, you don't give away much before you start to plate. So you just need...
You must be sure that you make a good full turn and step. If you, again, stop out in here and throw across your body, the tendency would be you might throw the ball well inside. So you got to turn quickly.
Step off this. Let's say the runner breaks. Now he breaks, and the infielders yell, there he goes. Okay, the pitcher has to have enough experience. You just cannot do it and stay in contact with the rubber. You must
don't break before you step off.
Yeah, you got to, no, you can't do anything before you step off.
Okay. And you set the example, and people recognize that you're wild, then they'll make you throw better.
And pitcher to know how to hold them.
Each morning during the week, a different aspect of the game is covered by the instructors. By the time Friday rolls around, the campers will be well-versed not only in hitting and pitching, but be able to make the plays that are a major part of playing good baseball.
It's very important, that's safety.
When you give the fella a direct line to the bag without getting in his way at all, aren't you risking a little bit of missing the tag altogether?
Oh, no, that's why you're on the left side.
What if he slides under you?
Yeah, what if he goes down and you miss the swipe?
I don't have velocity anymore. I lost speed a long time ago. That's not the problem. The problem is I have to do some adjustment. Now I should do everything slowly, because there's not a human being going to run the ball, like I said to you before. Okay, this is important, the little thing. Now,
safe. So you got to make sure the ball is in the glove when you make the tag.
And the umpire can see that.
Even if it's an inch out of the glove, if the umpire sees it, he's safe.
See, it's given some, slightly, see? That's what happened. That's the key. Exactly.
Throw the ball! Let it roll.
I know.
Well hit.
Oh, Henry, let it go.
Good.
Run down there, big
boy. Throw it.
Stay with it.
Now, once again, now, pitchers, as you're looking at second base, right-handed pitcher, you can see the first baseman out of the corner of your eye. I can see the guy at first base out of the corner of my eye. And all the first baseman's going to do, when the pitcher's in a set position, Jack, you be the pitcher there. Move over, well, you're okay right there. You can see me. Okay, look at second base. Now, you'll be able to see me. In a game, you'll be able to see me. As soon as you're set, I'm going to go right to the bag, and you throw right here. That's all you do.
If I put a sign on, if I'm going through the signs, okay? Yeah. Let's say I put the hit and run on. Nothing's on.
Okay.
And that's so when you use a takeoff.
Don't go in straight. Turn it a little bit. So I could give here. If I'm here, I'm in trouble. Turn it a little bit, and you're going to go right through.
Whenever in doubt, slide. Okay?
See, right in here.
See, we're going to go in here, and I'm going to try to knock him down.
And if he goes the other way, well, he's better than I am on that play.
Ain't
no going to
get me.
Flight.
Ain't no way. See, I could see the body.
Okay, so you watched him go. You saw him start
exactly.
To
now,
relax.
Now, okay, that's not too bad. Watch that ankle now. Watch that heel. Okay, don't jump. Don't jump. Glide right into that slot. If you're going right, you're rolling, and your right arm is coming around. If you're going left, you're rolling, and you're coming around with the left. Okay?
Okay.
Third, third!
Excellent, excellent. Okay, good.
Third, third!
Excellent, excellent. Yes, we know how to
act. Good, look good.
Outstanding.
Here we go. Got it, those pitchers. Excellent, excellent.
Watch out, back up. Some party.
Where'd you grow up as a kid?
Where was Vinnie Brewer?
Bryant.
Where was Billy Lowe's?
Who's got it?
Watch it, Roger, watch it!
Watch it! Running track!
We've got after that.
I got it.
You got it.
Ready? Here we go.
Beautiful.
Call it, Roger.
I got it.
Don't know how I'll run away. Make sure that you run.
Beautiful.
Yes, sir.
Hi, I'm John Mesko from Yo Belinda. I just want to thank everybody. It's been a great time, and I wish I could have done it when I was 20 instead of 50. Thank you.
I'm Jim Campbell from Irvine, California.
Hi there, Steve Firsoff, Huntington, New York. Stacy, I miss you. See you real soon. Hope you do well today. Love you.
Thanks, Marsha Gross. This beats the losers any day. Next year, too.
Very happy to be here at Vero Beach and be among all these great past ball players and with the 91 fellows that become new friends and associated with here in Vero Beach at the Dodger Complex. Just like to say hello to everybody back home in the Port Jervis and Milford area, which is in Pennsylvania and New York State. It's just nice to be here. Thank you.
Yeah, this is half of Saudi Arabia's contingent to Dodger Town adult baseball camp. We're having a great time. We've got a great bar here. We're really enjoying ourselves. Henry and I send regards back home.
Okay, Henry Cook from Dhahran, Saudi Arabia, the better half of the Saudi team. Hello to Bonnie, to Peter, to Allison, and especially to Ann.
Hi, I'm Len Blonder from Los Angeles, and I want to send my love to Michelle, Seth, Matthew, and Bree. Having a great time.
I'd like to thank all the folks at Veritex for making this possible, and it's a dream vacation for me, and I'd mostly like to thank my wife and children for having the patience to put up with me not being around for a week.
I just got a lot of thank yous to say to a lot of people who helped make this one of the greatest weeks of my life. I want to say thanks to my co-workers at the office who put up with me leaving every day at 3 o'clock to practice. To my Mexican friends at Van Nuys Sherman Oaks Park, who got me into shape for this week. And most especially, to my wife and kids who put up with all this garbage and me out playing ball all the time. It's been a great one. I caught for the first time in my life, played a whole game yesterday behind them with the catcher's equipment on, and it was a lot of fun.
I want to say hi to my mom, my sister, my brother, Adam, Nathan, Ed, Denise, and my wife. And thank you all for believing in me. So long.
Hi, everybody back home.
Hi, folks. This is half of Saudi Arabia's contingent to the adult baseball camp here in Dodger Town. We're having a great time. I'd like to say hello to my wife, Marcia, and son, Mark, and we'll be home soon.
Hey, everybody. I just wanted to thank Greg and Susie and Glenn for paying for this trip. I couldn't afford to do it myself, and thank my wife for letting me come.
This is the third year up with the big club, having the best year of my life. This is the greatest week in the whole world.
It's my first time here, having a great time. It's the greatest week I've spent. Coaches have been fantastic, and I'm going to look forward to coming back next year.
Yep.
Who's that?
Hey, guys, let's play ball!
Now the cameras have a chance to put all the things they've learned into practice.
Now hustle, hustle!
Yeah.
That's it, good eye, good eye!
Cover, cover! Hey,
down, 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 down!
What's the injury? Wait a minute, where's the injury? We're going to play the game under protest.
The managers have learned things, too. They've learned not to trust each other.
Fellas, back over there.
We'll take care of this.
And we can't catch Leo, is that
then
right?
Then we don't have a catcher.
Then we don't have a catcher.
We can't play.
Each afternoon of the camp is given to interleague games. This is a lot more fun than stretching and exercises. The campers really go all out to win these games, stretching sore and tired bodies to the limit.
My unbiased opinion is that it stinks.
To protest the entrance of coaches on this hapless team we're playing today.
Managers and coaches like to get involved as well. One of the favorite things they like to do is overmanage. Some managers will even do something extra to help their teams.
Bribery.
He was more interested in jockeying with the catcher, thinking about that than he was the game situation.
Yeah.
Where we're at, he's laughing, talking to Jaffe. Jaffe's got him in a good conversation going.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Some managers have a little bit of trouble believing what they see in some of these practice games.
There's going to be some scoring going on now. One.
Did you bring enough for everybody?
Number one.
Uno.
Number one.
Uno.
We're number one. We're going to win this thing by beating those humpy dumpies from over there.
All the way.
Hey, come on!
Yo, better go!
I don't believe I've ever seen anything like that.
That's a job.
I'll come you put your hat on when you pitch it. Oh, the sun is not out. I see. Go ahead.
Foul ball. What are you doing? Foul ball. Oh, if they would only ask me.
No way! Come on!
Hey! You're out!
Beautiful catch, Pada.
Would you take a roll on the ground chasing the fly ball if you weren't serious?
Come on. Get up there. Get up there, Sue B. Get up there. Let him know.
Watch it, Joe. Watch it. Slide, Joe. Slide.
That's the right.
Nice catch, man.
All right,
Hey, Sandy.
Those did an outstanding job. Now, I wished I could give you more, but there was a couple of plays out there that didn't go our way.
Oh, well, yeah. This is really serious.
You know, that bad. I mean, you know, we got integrity, too.
I really appreciate you, because we were really hurting, and you know, you kind of evened it up for us. And I appreciate it, okay?
Nice game. Okay, thanks a lot.
There you have it. There you have it.
Good, we'll see you tomorrow. Then.
Okay. Caught in the act.
There you go. Taggy!
Got it!
Yeah! That boy, 40!
That's three,
Hey, guy.
Hey.
See that guy sitting on the bench with the towel around him? See him?
Yeah.
If that guy doesn't look like Greg Malevi.
Hey, you're absolutely right. He does.
A thin Greg Malevi. Look at him. Doesn't he?
Yeah.
Look at him.
Yeah.
There you go, that's a triple!
Yeah!
Oh, boy!
Good job. Yeah, let's just run on the batter here.
Come on.
Jeez, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
Start all over. That's all.
He's clean.
Zero beat, with your head up high. Going. You were responsible.
Get him out! Get him out! Get him! Find
three! Goodbye. Auf Wiedersehen. So long. Adios. I'm some more runs.
Yes!
Last one.
Yeah! Hey, there's another boot!
Oh, you gotta be
what the hell?
Don Dreisel has a little bit of trouble believing what he just seen.
Come on, Eddie.
Of course, none of this is serious. This is all in the spirit of good fun.
Made up for that lump up there in the last inning, didn't I?
Okay, this is a championship game. How are you guys going to do?
We're going to beat them. Beat them bad.
You're unbeaten so far. Can you keep it up?
Absolutely. No problem. Coach Perry leading the way. No problem.
I'll pick the score of about 9-3.
9-3, you. Yep. Sarasota's going to win it 9-3.
9-3.
San Antonio has no chance.
And we will do it.
You're going to start today in a big game, aren't you?
Yeah. Well, I hope.
You take nothing less, right?
Nothing less.
Nothing less than winning.
Nothing less.
Okay, this is Sarasota's starting pitcher. Is the curve working?
If I can get it across the plate, all the pitches work. I don't know about the curve.
You got a slider today?
Very slight slider.
You got a fastball?
Very slow.
Do you have a win in you?
I got a win in. But we've got a great relief corps, so we're not worried. Undefeated.
Let's get it. Right.
Whoa, that's all right. My mama.
Can you guys beat these other guys?
We're going to do it.
Are you kidding?
Well, you believe it.
They're going to beat himself and their mother's one.
Easy.
My ball!
In the league championship game, Sarasota uses a home run ball to take an early lead. San Antonio comes back to tie the game later on, but Sarasota is the league champion with a 4-win, no loss, and 1-tie record. Three-run homer.
got to be musical, but I did like to see that.
You taught him how to do all that stuff, didn't you?
Well, yes, he had it himself.
That sucker went over the hill, didn't it?
Sit to hit.
That went over the hill.
That went over the hill. He hit it about 380, and shucks, that's the best thing I've seen since I've been down there.
You?
Yeah!
Made my contribution. Made my contribution.
Nice going.
Beat it out. When you beat them out like that, as good as five, maybe they gave me a base hit on that. I don't know yet. But it don't make any difference. I scored the run.
I'm having a fantastic time spending time talking to Duke and Carl Ferrello and Johnny Padres. It's a dream come true playing down here with all these guys. Lots of fun.
We really enjoyed the week. The coaches, the staff, everybody's been great. And we learned what they mean by the expression, bleeding Dodger blue.
Casey, Spike, Daddy's going to dedicate his first hit to you. Only trouble is I haven't gotten it yet. We're looking for it this afternoon, though. Hopefully you'll see it later on the tape.
Jill, Rachel, and Scott, you're the greatest, and I love it. And thanks for letting me come this week. This is the best present I've ever had in my life. Thanks for putting up with me. Thank you very much, Carol, for this trip, and I really appreciate it. I'm having a wonderful time. I'm hurting, but I'm waiting for my first hit. Thanks.
Carl Wessinger from Woodbury, New York. Having a wonderful time down here. I'd like to thank my brother and sister who gave me it as a birthday gift. Thank you.
I want to give special thanks to my wife, Linda, and my son, Bob, for affording me the opportunity to spend this glorious week here. And I'd like to thank Elijah Muhammad for that opportunity as well. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. I want to say thank you. Take care of yourselves. Baseball will be very, very good to me this year. I'm batting very well, and I'm catching the ball even better. I hope to be pitching today. And you all take care. See you later. Goodbye.
Junior Marquis, South Yarmouth, Cape Cod, Mass. When I was a kid, I was always on the playground playing baseball. And there came a time I had to stop doing that, get married and get serious. Now I come here every year to be on the greatest playground in the world. Great to be back in Dodger Town. Take care.
Hi, Jenny. Hi, PJ. Hi, Nana. Hi, Grandma and Grandpa. I'm over here in Vero Beach, and I'm stumbling all over myself. But I'm loving every minute of it. I'll see you when I get home.
Steve Ganley from Hackettstown, New Jersey. Just want to thank my Great Falls teammates and my coaches, Wes Parker, Preacher Rowe, and Terry Collins for a great week.
I'm Jody Anthony from Santa Ana, California. I just want to say that Coach McMullen sends in Ralph Branca to give me the hook and then to give me the potato head. I mean, is this a great country or what?
I'm Steve Fenley from Middletown, New Jersey. I'd just like to thank my wonderful wife, Jerry, for giving me absolutely the best birthday present I ever had. Thank you. And I'd like to thank all the people down here for such a great week.
My name is Steve Cammy from Briarcliff Manor, New York. I trained hard. I feel good. I think I'm ready. I want to thank my wife, Randy, and the rest of my family for sending me down here to have the week of my life. And all the people have been unbelievably supportive and nice. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Steve Adler from Moline, Illinois. I just want to say hello to everyone back in the heartland and dedicate this to Vern Krause.
Hi, I'm Ron Feenberg from Northridge, California. Hello to my lovely wife, Karen, my wonderful kids, Michael and Marnie. I love you and I miss you.
Ken Jaffe from Los Angeles. It's a beautiful day for baseball. Let's play two.
Don't worry about that at all.
For baseball to be very, very good to us.
I knew that, yes.
But we don't tell you what. Come to me on Friday afternoon, we'll talk to you.
Yes, we do, yeah. Well, thank you very much. And your panel will sign.
No autographs?
We'll sign, yeah. We can do that.
I'm all ready.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Merry Christmas to you.
That's nice. Evenings at the camper of time for rest and relaxation. Western Barbecue Night is a special treat, complete with country music, cowboy garb, and some mighty fine outdoor cooking.
to me, Beck.
There's something special about steaks cooked over a charcoal grill. Put that together with barbecue ribs and homemade chili and top it off with a roaring fire, and you have a night that's really something special.
Name is always awful.
Just point to the plane.
Follow us later.
Everybody's thinking of you. Yes, I love you.
Oh, listen to that.
Other evenings at camp are not too bad either. There's nothing wrong with the dining facilities at Dodger Town. After dinner, the Daily Potato Head Awards for outstanding performances by the campers during that day's games, along with entertaining speakers, round out the day's activities.
A go, Bob, especially when we see left-handed hitters coming up. All the big hitters want to get their arms extended so they can get the maximum leverage to be able to hit the ball for a distance. And you're seeing that more and more as the young players are getting bigger and bigger this year. All the young players that came in, they're striking out more, but they're wanting to hit more home runs. So you're going to get more leverage, more distance on the ball with the extension of the arms.
Hit the ball. Hit the ball, hit it hard. That was my favorite.
I knew he was going to start me off with something off the outside corner, a screwball or a fastball, and he would stay out there, stay away from me, unless he saw me jumping out there or he thought he had me set up, and only then would he come inside.
I came up in an era where I didn't think about anybody. I mean, he threw the ball, I hit it. I don't care whether it was left-handed or right-handed.
I was wondering why he put it under his arm. Why'd he just throw the ball up and catch? Why'd he waste time putting the glove off the ground?
Rob, I was 1.5 years old. I don't know, Rob.
And Pee-wee turned around and saw where everybody was, and as soon as he caught the ball, he just turned and threw it to first base and doubled McDougal off by about 2 feet.
Pete, you've got to learn some control and come up with a new pitch and have patience. And they worked on me 2 years.
Rowe pitched today. He pitched a complete game. He scattered 5 hits, 2 inside and 3 outside.
We had such a great club. We went through an era, and I don't think any of us ever realized what we were going through until it was much, much later. We had nothing really that we could say about it because we had a lot of things we could have said at that time.
Carl, it's 35 years, and realistically, after 25, I kind of got tired of it.
I think we're looked on up. The Yankees always had their particular type of class, but I think we've really became the kings of baseball.
Well, we walked a little further and I saw Tom Hayden with Bo Derek. And I said, Lord, Lord, Tom must have been real good. And he said, no, Bo was real bad.
And now go to the other side. And around.
One thing about the Dodger Town baseball camps is you never know who might show up. Here, Jane Fonda leaves the Thursday morning exercises.
Hand on one knee, circle an arm, reverse the other way, one arm at a time. One hand on one knee. Circle.
Get closer, reverse the
circle.
One more. Two.
Three. And one. Up and right, your right shoulder. Feel the stretch on the side of the
leg. Side of the head.
Other side. What?
Manager manager Tom Lasorda did so well in the exercise classes that he decided that he'd like to try to flex his muscles on the basketball court. After a quick game with Ann Drysdale, everybody agreed, Tom is very good at baseball.
What are you laughing at, Toby? You gotta dribble the ball.
No, you don't.
No. You gotta dribble the ball.
Hey, that's...
No.
Where are you from?
What do you do? How do you put the ball in play?
Once you check it.
How do you put the ball in play?
Once you check it.
You gotta either do this.
No.
How do you get out of bounds?
Defense checks the ball, gives
it
the
ball,
go.
No, you're
out of bounds.
That's where you're starting, out of bounds.
You gotta play defense.
Ah, you gotta play.
When's the last time
you gotta put the ball in motion. Let's go, 3-0.
I think that might have been a swan.
All right, now you're in play.
Second camp. I heard a little bit more from this camp than I did the last one. I want to thank my family for understanding the fact that this is something I absolutely love to do, and want them to be able to be proud of this tape. Thank you very much.
Hi, Joan. Hi, David. Hi, Stephen. Hi, Jody. This is what it's all about. And it's very warm, and we're going to do our calisthenics soon. And then... and then we're going to play, and you'll get a look at my taped-up legs, and and it's 10 seconds almost up because I'm getting tired of this stuff. That's it? Okay.
Bart Kaufman from Indianapolis. This is my second year of coming to Dodger Town for fantasy and fun with Jane Fonda and Duke Snyder, Carl Ferrillo, Don Drysdale, Tommy Lasorda. Great week, great weather, great food. We treat you like you're on a cruise. Can't wait to come back. I just hope that my body will hold out so I can come back for many more years.
Hi, everyone. I finally made it. I'm a Dodger. Thanks.
Hi, Rob Vines from San Marino, California. I want to thank my wife, Sherry, for giving me this trip for my 40th birthday. Say hi to Jennifer, Jill, and Michael, and for all of my Spanish-speaking clients. Baseball has been very, very good to me.
Thanks for the great time down here at Pear. Appreciate it. Sorry you hooked me. Thank everybody for all the time we've had down here, John and Teddy.
I'm Dickie Vaughn. I'm from Dallas, Texas. It's my first time here. It's wonderful. I love it. I'll come back. I'll be better.
Hi, Sharon Math. Well, I did it again, back down here in Florida. Weather's been great. Now looking forward to going up back to the snow. See you in a little while, and we'll talk about next year.
Hi, I'm Neil Adams from Reseda, California. I want to say hi to my wife, Sue. I was a catcher. I had to be a catcher because I can only see 60 feet, 6 inches. I played for Great Falls with Wes Parker, Preacher Rowe, and Terry Collins. Had a great time.
Hi, I'm Jerry Saylor from Portland, Oregon, and I'd like to say hi and thanks to my wife, Sharon, and Adam and Jordan. Thanks for letting me be down here and be a little boy again.
Hi, my name is Nick Finelli, and I'm from Norridge, Illinois. And this is my second time at Boys Town this year, so thanks to my wife and to my family. Love you all. See you soon. Having a great time.
Leland Arcee from Walport, Oregon. I'd just like to say hi to all my fans out there.
Hi, I'm Harold Ganey, and I live in Woodland Hills with my beautiful wife, Nora. I'd like to say hi to Nick, Sean, Pat, Bob, Alan, and especially Ione. Having a great time.
Jay Luga here from Brooklyn, New York. Born and bred there. Hi, Don. Nice weather here. Hi, Mom, Dad, Steve, Rich, and Bob. You guys blew it by not coming down. See ya.
Hi, Ken Corday from North Hollywood, California. I'd like to say hi to my wife, Sherry, and thank her for putting up with me coming down here for a week, and it's been great. See you next year.
Bumps and bruises, but this is a day of the game. Are the campers going to be ready?
Morning, team.
And it burns.
You don't think you can win?
Well, we're going to try.
It's going to be windy, so that's going to give somebody a break.
We're having trouble suiting up. Winning is secondary. Getting dressed is the first priority.
It's a proven fact that that the instructors are going to win.
Well, they usually
do. They win every year.
I know.
You know, but I think last place is most important today.
We can win both of them. Matter of fact, the first one's for pride, the second one's for the fun of it. Somebody said that the old-timers put their pants on the same way we do, they just throw it a little harder still, so we're going to work hard at it.
On Friday morning, the campers and instructors get together for group and team photo sessions. Just like the Dodgers teams of the past in the big leagues.
Okay, look in here.
We're gonna break some hearts today.
Betcha.
Move closer. I can see you.
Say, Al, about
another one. Okay, the last for Sarasota?
No. Not yet, not yet, not yet, not yet.
What's this?
Why
are you just getting pictures of Jane? Herbie, you're getting closer.
Look here. Look here.
Look here. That quarter's on the way.
You've been waiting for that afternoon.
Oh, yes.
This is it. It's game day. This is what the campers have been working so hard all week for, the chance to play the instructor. Let's relax and watch and see how they do.
kids.
Both games, 3-2, the Dodgers beat Sarasota. They're 2-2. They have a home and city in hand for the Sarasota team. They were the champions.
Base hit.
place to go. Oh, Rettmer.
Thank you. here is the Emperor of Light Steel, number 6, Carl Furlow. This is what is known as the Mazorda ship.
Thank you.
Didn't dampen the enthusiasm of the week's activities.
Let me say from the bottom of my heart that I am really, really sorry that the rain came, the big Dodger in the sky did not look down on us all the way, and I am really sorry that the Albuquerque Club was the only club that did not go to go out on the field today. But now last night, this may be the only little sentimental thing I'm going to say all night. I heard some of these guys that got up here last night, Lou Johnson and some of the others, and they mentioned two words. Dodger family. We are a very, very proud Dodger family. You can go back to the people that played in Brooklyn and the great stars that played in L.A., down through our minor league instructors. It is a close, close-knit family. And you fellas now know that. You're a big part of it. We're very proud of the whole thing. I'd like to have all of the instructors, would you please stand up, all of the instructors, preacher, everybody, can stand up a minute, will you please?
Shortstop, saw yes.
Fellas, congratulations. I think we all realized that by the end of the week, we were the best team. If you lead a good life, say your prayers and go to church when you die, you will go to Dodger.
Usually I'm not lost for words. This is a complete surprise. I want to tell you, in my lifetime, I don't think I have ever, and remember, I'm 68 and a half years old. I have never attended anything in my entire lifetime, I will say this here tonight publicly, where I have seen people get together to recognize and appreciate each other. It is something that when you go home, I know that I could never express to people my real, true feelings, because you have to be here to do it. The Dodgers can be very, very proud of what they did for all of us this week, because they did something for us in knitting people together from all over the United States, Saudi Arabia, and Montreal. Say is thank you so very, very much, but be very, very proud that you belong to an organization like this.
You did a good job.
job. And since I've been here observing all the campers, I find a great similarity. When you guys roll in here Sunday night, you're all kind of shy, a little bit scared, innocent, clean-cut looking bunch. And now you've turned into a bunch of alcoholics and sex maniacs. Just like the rest of us. Now you know how to play the game.
This is a serious award. The Cy Young Award. This goes to a man that every time I looked out, he seemed to be pitching. Yeah. Yeah. Did an outstanding job for Great Falls. Glenn Scott. Won so many times in the National League. It's a beautiful little award. It goes to a man who has been here one, two, three times. I'm not too sure how many. He plays shortstop. Always gives everything he's got. Mike O'Shea. Yeah! Does everything that you want to see a catcher do to win a ball game. And this fella stood out above all. It's called the Golden Nail Award, and it's given to Randy Hazel. The next award is for an... Let me just show you what it looks like. It's called the Los Angeles Dodger 4th Annual Adult Camp, the Jock of the Camp Award. This...
What are you laughing about, Lou?
This award goes to a guy every year who is an outstanding athlete. A guy that is out there and does his job. The managers are proud of him, and all of the managers voted on this. And the guy that gets the award this year is a guy that I saw out there pitching on one leg and trying to hit, trying to run, Mike Wyman.
Satisfying things I think I get out of this camp is to have these guys come up and tell you how great they've done since you worked with them. And I know that you thank the fellows that have helped you the most. And these guys have come up to me and said, see, that batting tee has helped me. Well, that's the greatest thing we can get out of this, is for you guys to improve and get better. And no matter what it is, pitching, fielding, or whatever it might be. But the batting champion has worked hard, I'll tell you. And I have noticed each year that he has come down here that he has gotten so good. You know, he never played baseball as a youngster. But all of a sudden, this guy has dedicated himself to the game of baseball. I don't know how he does his job, to be honest with you, because he has gotten so good. But Tom Hayden's our batting champion.
History, you will find that the National League Most Valuable Player usually belongs to the pennant winner. American League's the same way. The guy that gets that award usually belongs to the winning team. And it's no different this year. We were really amazed and surprised when we saw this guy play. We found out he could not only play the out in the field. He made a hell of a catch over here today, diving for one of Chico's line drives in the middle of the infield. But he plays the piano as well as he hits and well as he plays. And totally. What we certainly appreciate that, and I just hope that we all pass the along the same path somewhere along the way, and we all see you back here in 1987. Good night, and have one hell of a night.
I wonder if you